will tell you about a small, really simple problem which has arisen from our everyday research work. Actually, we are a group of researchers who are trying to understand how will be climate change impact the energy industry of Russia. Well, such an impact is still evident, and we know that it will be more and more pronounced during many next years. The climate is an incredibly complicated thing, but fortunately, we are interested in long-term changes only. So the timescales which are of interest for us are 10 to 30 years. Well, there are different one of basic data source for climate forecast are results of global climate simulations. There is an international project which averages such simulation data on different scales. For our problem, monthly resolution will be exactly what do we need. Daily, it would be hardly supposed to be efficient to use data of daily resolution. There are plenty of tools in R to treat such a problem. The logic behind each approach is pretty the same. We have to understand which month are we going to subset, to apply a function, for example, spatial averaging, and visualize and enjoy. So that's perfect. Sorry for title. It is precipitation. You may obtain with such tools this plot very easily. That's perfect. That is what was like precipitation during historical experiment over area on Minsk. But if we look on the temperature in the same area, the picture is still not so perfect. Precipitation plot look very much like truth. Precipitation has high variance and gamma distribution. Temperature is much more predictable, and seeing on this plot, we may understand that something went wrong. If we smooth the time series, we see that definitely is very wrong. And what is it? It is because modelers of Smith-Pett have aggregated data around different days of the month for different years. It's pretty a surprise for climate researcher, but so it is. It seems that we have used a slightly more smart approach. For example, just use linear approximation and interpolate to regular monthly date. Well, our plot now looks dramatically different, I would say. If we compare our initial so quick and easy approach and our more or less correctly obtained this green line, we will see that our initial approach has distorted dramatically the structure of time series. We would see if we could trust our initial approach, we would think that there is a regime jump for air temperature, which isn't a case. So, what I would like to say to our users, be very careful with data which you use. What I would like to say to our developers, please do not push users to a wrong direction. Please do not promote solution which hide from user necessary steps in analyzing the data. So that's all.